Dear students, good morning to all. In the last session, we have discussed the Colgate properties concept till the elevation in boiling point, and I started depression in freezing point also. There we have discussed vapor pressure versus temperature graph there. So we have seen freezing point of solvent, freezing point of solution curves. Okay, during the freezing of the solution, there exists a equilibrium between liquid solvent and solid solvent only. By this equilibrium only, we can understand that graphical representation. We already discussed that part. Now see, in this class, I am discussing the remaining part of depression and freezing point. Here, what is the definition of depression and freezing point? Definition equation, corresponding units, how that is calculated, and we have to prove as a Colgate property, and from that how to find molecular weight of the solute and how to experimentally determine that depression freezing point. See one by one. So definition, already we have discussed, if you take the pure solvent, for this if you add a non-volatile solid solute, solution will be obtained. So for this solution also we have vapor pressure. So we know this vapor pressure is P naught, this vapor pressure is PS, and this freezing point, pure solvent freezing point, is T naught, this is TS. Already we have discussed in lowering in vapor pressure, P naught greater than PS. In this, from the graphical representation, in yesterday's class we have discussed that one, that is T naught greater than TS. So the difference between these T naught, that is a freezing point of pure solvent, and TS, freezing point of solution containing non-volatile solute, is simply nothing but depression freezing point. What is exact definition? The decreasing of freezing point of a pure solvent by the addition of a non-volatile solid solute. Okay, that is mathematically denoted as delta TF. Delta TF is equal to T naught of freezing point minus TS of freezing point. As per that, what are these units, the corresponding units? It is a temperature unit. This is also in temperature units. Therefore, this is again temperature unit, that may be in Kelvin or degree centigrade. Now see, calculated equation. Okay, like elevation in boiling point, in this also we can derive this mathematical expression. This calculated equation is delta TF is equal to KF into molality. So where KF is equal to molal depression constant, or this is also known as cryoscopic constant. And like KB, this KF also characteristic property of given solvent. It is characteristic property of a given solvent. So that means it depends on the solvent factors only. Like KB expression, here also we can represent this KB, KF, by using its latent heat of fusion. This is R T naught of freezing point square by 1000 into L fusion, latent heat of fusion, this is per gram. Or this is also represented R T naught of freezing point square by 1000 into this delta H fusion, this is enthalpy of fusion, by molecular weight of the solvent. Now take it to its numerator, this is molecular weight of the solvent. Or according to second law of thermodynamics also, we can represent in terms of entropy of fusion, that is also represented in this manner. But according to second law of thermodynamics equation, what is delta S? Q reversible by T. That means from this we can write delta S fusion is equal to delta H fusion by T melting point or T freezing point. So based on this, we can write this expression as, so take one freezing point to denominator. From that we can write this is T naught of freezing point by 1000 into delta H fusion by freezing point of solvent. It is written as delta S fusion per mole of the substance into molecular weight of the solvent. So for a given solvent, there is a definite Kf, that is molar depression constant or cryoscopic constant. It is in terms of latent heat of fusion. It is in terms of enthalpy of fusion. It is in terms of entropy of fusion. What is this fusion expression? Fusion expression is when you convert solid into liquid. Whatever this delta H there, per mole is enthalpy of fusion. Per gram is enthalpy, this is latent heat of fusion. During this process, whatever the entropy change there, that is delta S fusion. So, if you know these three values, we can find this Kf value. So, anyway, what is this calculated equation? Delta Tf is equal to Kf into M, where Kf is the molar depression constant or cryoscopic constant, that is mathematically obtained in these three ways. And you know M is the molality of the given solution. Okay, here we have to see what is molar depression freezing point exact definition. See, definition of the molar depression constant, we know depression in freezing point equation delta Tf is equal to Kf into M. So from this, if you take the 1 molar solution, we are getting this molar depression constant definition. If M is equal to 1, default what is this? This is Kf is equal to delta Tf. What is delta Tf? So it is a depression freezing point produced by 1 molar solution. 1 molar solution. So like that we can define this Kf. And what about corresponding units of the Kf? So from this, what is the Kf expression? Delta Tf by molality. So this is equal to, you know, delta Tf unit is Kelvin or degree centigrade, and molar inverse, or we can represent Kelvin. What is molar inverse? That is kg per mole. So like Kb, Kf also having the same type of unit. Just I completed this expression. What is this depression freezing point calculated equation? Delta Tf is equal to Kfm, where Kf is the characteristic property of given solvent. So we can find Kf from the heat of fusion, or latent heat of fusion, or entropy of fusion, and this corresponding units and definition. Now see this proof as a Colgate property. Proof as a Colgate property. Delta Tf. Proof as a Colgate property. What is its mathematical equation? Delta Tf is equal to, this is Kf into molality. From this we can write Kf into, what is molality? Number of moles of solute by weight of solvent in kg. Suppose for a given quantity of the solvent, what we can write? This is W1 is constant, and Kf is also characteristic property of the solvent. That's why this is also constant. Therefore, delta Tf is directly proportional to number of moles of the solute. From this, we can understand delta Tf is a Colgate property. So, like this, in every case, we can prove that is as a Colgate property. Next, molecular weight determination of the solute from this Colgate property. Molecular weight of the solute calculation from delta Tf. We know delta Tf is equal to Kf into M, that is Kf into, what is molality? Number of moles of solute per 1 kg of the solvent. That means weight of the solute by molecular weight of the solute into 1000 by weight of the solvent in grams. From this we can write this molecular weight of the solute, that is equal to Kf into, so weight of the solute by delta Tf into 1000 by W1 in grams. By using this we can find out molecular weight of the solute. So from this what we can write? Molecular weight of the solute is inversely proportional to Colgate property. Like this, this relation, molecular weight is inversely proportional to Colgate property, is obtained in every Colgate property case. And finally, see how to get this is from the experiment. Experimental determination of delta Tf. Actually, this is obtained from the Ras-Camphor method. So in this method, we are using camphor is used as a solvent. Camphor is used as a solvent. Okay, why we are using camphor as the solvent? Actually, we know this delta T of mathematical equation. What is this expression? Kf into molality, where Kf is the molar depression constant. It is a characteristic property of the solvent. Every solvent has its individual value. Suppose if you take the water, water molar depression constant is 1.86 Kelvin kg mole inverse. Similarly, if you look at camphor, Kf of camphor, this is approximately 35 Kelvin kg mole inverse. If you look at these two values, Kf of camphor is nearly 20 times of Kf of water. Okay, if you take this mathematical expression, for if m is equal to 1, 1 molar solution considered. When 1 molar solution is considered, what is this delta Tf? Delta Tf is equal to Kf. So, in the experimental determination, if you get more value in the science aspect, that precision and accuracy concept must be applicable to get the accurate values. So, if the Kf value is high, then your resultant value has less error. If the Kf value is less, the resultant value has more error. To minimize the error, we have to use more Kf solvent. That's why the best solvent to get the molecule, to get this experimental delta Tf is camphor. So that camphor is used as solvent in the RAS camphor method. Okay, this is the advantage of camphor solvent in this method. Camphor Kf value is nearly 20 times more than that of Kf of water. If more value there, we are getting less error, so more accurate value. Okay, in this method, how do you get exactly this experimental delta Tf? This is obtained from mathematical expression. What is our definition equation? Experimentally, we have to find out delta Tf is equal to T naught of freezing point minus Ts of freezing point. Find freezing point of both solvent and solution having a non-volatile solute experimentally. The difference will be the experimental delta Tf. So, like this, in depression freezing point, we can follow like that. And see, last colligative property, that is osmotic pressure. So, in this osmotic pressure also, we are going to deal these points. Diffusion, what is osmosis? Next, what is osmotic pressure definition? Corresponding definition equation, units, calculated equation, proof as a colligative property, molecular weight of solute determination, experimental determination of that osmotic pressure. Apart from these, we have to study even what are those isotonic solutions, hypertonic solutions, hypotonic solutions, and even reverse osmosis, endoosmosis, and exoosmosis. In endoosmosis, we are going to study hemolysis. In exoosmosis, we are going to study plasmolysis. So, under osmotic pressure, we have to know all these points. What is diffusion, osmotic pressure, corresponding definition, definition equation, units, calculated equation, proof as a colligative property, molecular weight of the solute determination, experimental determination, and isotonic solutions, hypertonic solutions, hypotonic solutions, reverse osmosis, endoosmosis, and exoosmosis. See one by one these. What is the diffusion process? Suppose if you take the two different concentrated solutions of the same solution and separated by normal membrane. Normal membrane. So, this is solution 1. This is solution 2 with concentration C1, C2. If C2 greater than C1, then what will happen? Membrane allows the passage of solute particles. It allows the passage of solute particles. When two different concentrations of the same solution separated by membrane, thus now the solute particle starts migration from higher concentration to lower concentration. So solute migrate from higher concentration to lower concentration side till the equal concentration on both sides. This process is called diffusion. It is a phenomenon of migration of solute particle from higher concentration to lower concentration through the membrane to get the same concentration on both sides when they are separated by membrane. Similarly, we can understand osmosis. In osmosis, we are using, instead of membrane, use semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane, that is SPM, semi-permeable membrane. So what is the purpose of the semi-permeable membrane? It allows the passage of only solvent molecule. Now we have to notice this difference. Normal membrane allows the passage of solute particle, whereas semi-permeable membrane allows the passage of solvent molecules only. By this only we can understand osmosis. What is osmosis? Same concept. When the two different concentrated solutions of the given solution separated by semi-permeable membrane, what happened to get the equal concentrations on both sides, then some change takes place. What is that change? The change will be noticed in terms of migration of solvent molecules only. Now solvent molecule starts to migrate. So here if C2 greater than C1 concentration, so where more solute there, solute content is more in second solution than first solution. So from lower concentration means, less solute, more solvent there indirectly. Therefore, from lower concentration to higher concentration side, solvent migration starts, and that will continue till the equal concentrations on both sides. Therefore, what is the osmosis? It is a phenomenon of migration of solvent molecules from lower concentration side to higher concentration side. Or sometimes this is a pure solvent, one side take the pure solvent, second side solution. Even this case also, in pure solvent it is only solvent, but in solution there is some solute also. Therefore in this comparison, compared with solution, pure solvent has more solvent. That's why it is a phenomenon of migration of solvent molecule from lower concentrations to higher concentration side, or pure solvent to solution side, through the semi-permeable membrane till the equal concentration on both sides when they are separated by semi-permeable membrane. Already I mentioned this point, semi-permeable membrane is used to migrate only solvent molecules. Actually, semi-permeable membranes are natural semi-permeable membranes there. Artificial semi-permeable membranes there, natural semi-permeable membrane, egg membrane and cell walls, okay, like this pig's bladder, all these can taken as a natural semi-permeable membrane. And what about artificial semi-permeable membrane, especially calcium phosphate and cupric ferrocyanide, these are used as artificial semi-permeable membrane. Anyway, semi-permeable membrane purpose is it allows only these solvent molecules. Okay, now we can see what is osmotic pressure. So osmotic pressure, okay, when you take the osmosis arrangement during this osmosis process, we can obtain this osmotic pressure. This is one vessel having a definite concentrated solution with a density D. In this, inverted Thistle funnel will be used. Inside portion only solution having a definite density D. This inverted Thistle funnel mouth will be closed with a semi-permeable membrane. And outer portion will be completely taken as a pure solvent. Outer portion is a pure solvent inverted Thistle funnel inner portion having a solution having a definite concentration or density D. These two separated by semi-permeable membrane. So if you take this arrangement, starting I have taken solution level up to A. So when this solution is allowed to contact with pure solvent, which are separated by semi-permeable membrane, now osmosis process takes place. What is osmosis? It is a phenomenon of migration of solvent molecule from pure solvent to solution site. So these pure solvent molecule enter into solution site. Now the level will be raised and let final level will be B. You know A is what is this level before osmosis, and B is the level in that column after osmosis. Now we can find this hydrostatic column. H is equal to B minus A. This is a hydrostatic column H obtained during this osmosis process. Okay, when you take this osmosis process, whatever the hydrostatic column H is obtained, due to this hydrostatic column, some pressure will be exerted. That pressure is calculated by P is equal to H into D into G. So this is nothing but osmotic pressure. This osmotic pressure is denoted as pi. That pi is equal to H into D into G. So what is osmotic pressure? This pi is osmotic pressure. H is hydrostatic column H during this osmosis phenomenon. And D is the density of the solution. G is gravity value. How do you exactly define this osmotic pressure pi? It is pressure exerted by hydrostatic column H during the osmosis process. Okay, it is one of the definition. Or another definition, here first take this arrangement. Already I given first definition. What is the definition? One, so pi is equal to HdZ. This is only definition equation. And what is the second definition? First take this osmosis process, completely allow this process. Now you know initial level A and final level B. At this stage, after completion of osmosis, now apply external pressure. Apply external pressure on solution side to restore its original level. That means it is a minimum external pressure. What is this osmotic pressure? It is minimum external pressure required on solution side to prevent the entry of solvent molecules into the solution when they are separated by semipermeable membrane. Like that, we can take the osmotic pressure definition during the osmosis phenomenon. Okay, this is a definition equation. What is this? Pi is equal to HdZ. And another definition, it is a minimum external pressure required on the solution side to prevent the entry of solvent molecules into the solution when they are separated by semipermeable membrane. We know the definition and definition equation. What about units? These units are the pressure units only. So we know these three. Now see the calculated equation. Okay, definition equation. Here, this osmotic pressure equation is obtained by using Van't Hoff theory of dilution. According to Van't Hoff theory of dilution, solute particle in dilute solution is simply behaving as gas molecule. So this, by using this concept only, we will get this osmotic pressure definition, osmotic pressure equation. So what is this osmotic pressure pi equation? By using Van't Hoff theory of dilute solutions, what we can understand, in every dilute solution, whatever the solute particle there, that will be simply behaving as a gas molecule, obeys all gas laws. We know gas laws. What are those? Boyle's law, Charles law, Charles 2 law, that is Gay-Lussac's law, Avogadro's law, and even ideal gas equation. So like gas laws, here also Van't Hoff, Boyle's law there, Van't Hoff, Charles law, and Van't Hoff, Avogadro's law, Van't Hoff, Gay-Lussac's law. So like this there, and even like ideal gas equation, PV is equal to NRT, pi V is equal to NRT there. What about this Van't Hoff, Boyle's law? So at a constant temperature and for a given moles of solute, this osmotic pressure is inversely proportional to its volume. You know, P is inversely proportional to volume, that is Boyle's law. Similarly, in Charles' law, this is for a given moles of the solute in dilute solution, that is constant osmotic pressure, volume is directly proportional to temperature. If you take the Charles Tula, for a given moles of solute in dilute solution at constant volume, osmotic pressure is directly proportional to temperature. Or we can take at constant temperature and volume, osmotic pressure directly proportional to number of moles of solute particle in the dilute solution. By using this Van 't Hoff gas laws, finally we will get this osmotic pressure mathematical equation. It is like in the form of ideal gas equation. We know what is ideal gas equation. PV is equal to nRT. Like this, this Van 't Hoff theory of dilute solution gives pi V is equal to nRT. This is nST, where S is same as that of R only. Pi V is equal to nRT or nST. From this only we can simplify this expression as pi is equal to, take this volume to this side, n by v into st, where n by v, number of moles per 1 liter of the solution is molarity, that will be taken as c, cst, pi is equal to cst. So this is the mathematical equation, which is calculated equation and which is obtained from the Van 't Hoff dilute solutions. So that equation is pi is equal to cst. Okay, based on this equation, we can follow numericals, and the remaining part will be discussed in the next session.